Okay, so I've reproduced our matrix that we created by doing the dynamic programming sequence alignment between Miss and Mrs. And now it's time to interpret what we have here. We see right here our optimum cost is for an alignment that gives us a cost of 2 right here. Now when I'm looking to reconstruct where that came from, I can either compute the three places that that came from here or here or here, and then choose the minimum to decide which path to go down. In this case, I've already recorded how I got to this 2. So I got to this 2 by adding 1 to this one right here, and I also got to this 2 by advancing on both the Miss and the Misses, and then doing a match between the S of Miss and the last S of Misses. So let's go ahead with this 2 and see what our sequence alignments will be. So let me write down, I have one right here. Okay, so now I'm going to, the first one I'll do is I will trace back down this way. So to go from here to here requires that I go backwards on each word. So that means my S got aligned with my S right here. Now this 2 here came from right here. So that means to go back from that direction requires that I backtrack on the step back a character on the Misses. You can see that. So the E of Misses got aligned with a blank on the Miss because I do not proceed anywhere on the Miss. So that E right here got aligned with a blank. I had to insert a blank on the Miss because I did not proceed through the Miss at all. So there's that right there, and that got me to this point right here. Now if you pause right here, let's go ahead and continue. So from this point right here, I got to this point from two ways, this way and this way. So let me go down this way right here. So that means to get to this point, I had to advance on both the Miss and the Misses. So that gives me an alignment between the S and the S, like so. Now this one, this entry right here came from this 0. So that means I advance on the Misses, but not on the Miss. So I have to insert a blank on the Miss. Okay. Now this right here, 0, came from only this location, and that means I advance on both the Miss and the Misses. So there's my advancing on both the Miss and the Misses. This 0 right here came from here. That means this M got matched. This M right here got matched against this M right here. Okay, so that's one alignment that I get, and here is my green to show me that particular alignment, dark green. And we can see it has a cost of 2 because this is 0, 0, insert a blank is 1, cost of 0, insert a blank is 1, 0. So the cost is 2 there altogether. Okay, let's do another alignment and see what I have. Another proposed alignment here. This time I'll track myself with blue. Okay, so I start from right here with this 2, and to get to this 2, cost of 2, the second way of doing that is by following this path right here. Following this path means I advanced on the Misses, but not on the Miss. So I advanced on the Misses, but not on the Miss. So there'd be a blank right there that got inserted on the Miss. Okay, this 1 came from this 0 right here. And again, that's advancing on the Misses, but not on the Miss. Oh dear, I don't quite have enough room. Let me just make a quick adjustment to my positioning so I have enough room there. And I've got a blank on the Miss, and I advance on the Misses to go right here. Okay, now this 0 came from right here, which means I match up between the S on Miss and the S on Misses right here. This 0 right here, this 0 right here, came only from this 0 here. So that means I advance on the S from the Miss and the S from the Misses right here. And then from this point on, it will be the same as what I had before. So the I gets matched against the I and the M against the M. Okay, and so there are two possible matches right there. And let's see if there's another. Let's see, I've done this one right here. I thought there was another way. Yes, there's another way of doing this, and that is this one could have been reached from here. So let's trace that one back as well. Okay, and I'll track that back with red this time. Okay, so and that's going to be this right here will be the difference. So to do that, I match the 2 comes from here because I want to end up at this point right here. Okay, so the 2 right here came from advancing on both of them right here. And then this 2 here came by advancing only on the misses but not on the miss. So I need to insert a blank right there. So that's that. And then this one right here, rather than advancing on both, I'm going to advance on the misses, but not on the miss. So advance on the misses, but not on the miss right there. So blank right there. And now at this point, I follow this track down, which I've already done right here. I've already done it right here. Okay, and I think that's the only 3 possible alignments that I can obtain by starting at the optimal alignment right here and backtracking through my optimum weights. So that's the end of this example right here.